I think President Trump has the wind at his back. You know, the issues that this election are going to be fought on, the economy, immigration, America's standing around the world. President Trump has a decisive advantage in all of those areas. And so I think he has an excellent chance of winning on November 5th. I would say that 2020 was a once-in-a-lifetime election. You know, the COVID pandemic resulted in a lot of changes on the fly in how we were conducting the election. Thankfully, the legislature responded to that. Governor Kemp has signed into law sweeping election integrity reforms over the last three legislative sessions. The Georgia Republican Party has built what I believe is the best election integrity program in the United States. We have many more eyes on the process than we did in 2020. So I'm very confident we're going to have a fair election, and I believe if we have a fair election that Donald Trump's going to win and win with a margin. We know what happened when we weren't together in 2020, and we've been suffering for 3.5 years as a result. We are all together now to get Donald Trump back in the White House. It's really the strongest I've seen in a long time. When you think about it, we have had the governor of Georgia for 20 years. We have every constitutional office is held by a Republican. Our General Assembly is controlled by Republicans. Our congressional delegation is majority Republican. So we are a very strong Republican state, and I think people are going to see that in the November election results. I think Democrats are divided in Georgia like they are all over the nation. I don't think they're certain that they want Joe Biden to be their nominee, number one. I think there's a real divide between far-left progressives and other parts of the country that are pulling the party further and further to the left. When we go through the 2024 election, the first thing we have to do is have it certified. And we have elections board members all over our state that are going to examine the process, make sure it was fair, and then they're going to certify that election. Now, if it's a very close election, we may, as happened in 2020, file a lawsuit to contest the election results if we have a good faith basis to do so. But yes, once those legal processes play out, when we get to the end of the day, I'm going to accept the result, whatever it is, and I expect the result to be Donald Trump winning Georgia's 16 electoral votes. And to see